Friends, good morning all of you.
I am Anamika, your bio teacher, and now I am going to discuss about the question answer of chapter 2, that is nutrition in animals. In the previous video, you have already seen the different types of the objective questions and short answer type questions. So today, mainly we will discuss about the long answer type questions. So let's see. First question is, how is nutrition carried out in hydra and frog? Hydra that engulfs its food using a finger-like projection, that is called tentacles. Tentacles, they are mainly the finger-like projection which is used for capturing the food. The prey gets killed and is passed into the mouth. Further digestion and absorption occurs inside their body. In frog, actually in frog, what happened? They have the unique type of tongue. They have the sticky tongue. Actually in the saliva, in their saliva, sticky substance is present and it is attached to the lower jaw. Frog's tongue is mainly attached to the lower jaw and it is rolled also. So further, by the use of this sticky tongue, they can catch their prey. And with the help of the digestive juices, which is further digested and absorbed inside their body. Second question, that is a draw a well-labeled diagram to depict nutrition in amoeba. I think we have discussed in the chapter that amoeba, that is a unicellular organisms, mainly belongs to the group protozoa, and they have the irregular shape. In their body shapes, they have the false feet, that is called pseudopodia. So these are the false feet of amoeba, that is called pseudopodia, which helps in capturing the food and also for the movement. So that's why it is known as pseudopodia. Pseudo means false and podia means food. So when the food particles comes in the path of the protozoa, that means amoeba, so pseudopodia first moves in that direction to capture the food items. I think this is clear for the diagram. And after some times, what happens? It completely surrounds the food particles. And after that, food vacuole is formed with the help of the digestive juices that is secreted inside their body. The food is digested and digested food is further mixed with their body and absorbed also. So this is the diagram by which we can explain the digestion or the nutrition that takes place in amoeba. The next question is, write the role of the small intestine in the human digestive system. As we know that in the small intestine, the complete digestion and absorption of the food takes place. So the muscles of the small intestine mix the food with the digestive juices and secrete some juices of their own. Actually, they also receive the juices from the mainly the duodenum, the first part of the small intestine, which receive the juices from the other parts also, like liver, pancreas, and it also secretes some own juices also. And altogether, they helps in the digestion of the food. And in a small intestine, the finger-like projection that's present in the small intestine, that is called villi. And villi, that mainly increases the surface area. So these are the small finger-like projection. And in villi, the various minute microvilli are present. So what is the function of this? They increases the surface area for the absorption of the food. So in this way, we can say that in a small intestine, complete digestion and absorption of food takes place. Next, what happens? Question number 4. What happens to the undigested food in the human body? The undigested food from the small intestine is passed to the large intestine. The food that is in semi-solid form. Large intestine absorbs water and other necessary nutrients, that means some salts also, from the undigested food and pushes it to the rectum.
In rectum, it is stored in the feces and extracted out of the body through anus, and that process is called ejection. The next question is, write about the role of the stomach in human digestive system. A stomach that acts as a mixer and grinder, which churn the food. The stomach was secrete. Actually, as we know that a stomach, that is a J-shaped structure, and inside the wall of the stomach, that secrete various types of the digestive juices, and along with the digestive juices, it also secretes HCl, mucus. HCl mainly kills the bacteria. It also makes the medium acidic for the partial digestion of the protein. Mucus prevent the stomach wall from the acidic attack. And apart from this, digestive juices are also secretes. And what is the function of the stomach? It mainly, that you can say that how mixer work. Okay, so same, it also churn the food. It churn the food, and after that means the partial digestion with the help of the digestive juices that is secreted from the wall of the stomach, that food is called chyme. And that is further moved to the small intestine. The last question, explain the digestive system in the ruminants with a well-labeled diagram. Actually, the ruminants are the mainly those animals. Ruminants are the grass-eating animals which can chew their cud. Right now I am going to discuss that the ruminants have a special types of the digestive system. Actually, their stomach is divided into the four chambers. And what are the four chambers? That is rumen, reticulum, omasum and abomasum. So this is the, now I am going to show you one pic. You can say, this is the, you can see here, this is the diagram of the ruminants, mainly the cow. This is the diagram of the cow. So this is the oesophagus. Actually, what ruminants can do, first it chew the food, it partially chew the food, and then it goes to the first chamber. This is the rumen, and rumen is the largest chamber. This is the rumen, and this is the largest chamber of the stomach of the ruminants. Here it is partially digested and it is converted into curd. The partially digested food, that is called curd, which is again brought back to the mouth. And whenever those animals free, they chew their curd. And this process is called rumination, bring back the curd to the mouth. And then it comes to the, after chewing the curd, it again comes to the rumen, where further digestion takes place, and after that it goes to the reticulum, the second chamber. This is the reticulum. Here also some digestion of the food occurs with the help of the some microorganisms which is present, and after that it goes to the omasum, and the partial absorption of the food also takes place in omasum, and after that it goes to the last chamber, that is called abomasum. Abomasum is called true stomach of the ruminants. Why? Because in abomasum, HCl that is secreted, that is mainly secreted inside the human body in the stomach. So that's why it is called the true stomach. And where the microorganism that is present and it kills, and it also, that means, makes the medium acidic for the digestion of the protein. And after that, food goes to the partially digested food, that goes to the small intestine. In the small intestine, complete digestion of the food occurs, and nutrients are also absorbed by the wall of the small intestine, and further food moves to the large intestine. And here the colon is the present, where some cellulose digesting bacteria is present, which helps in the digestion of the cellulose. So that's why ruminants can digest cellulose but not the human beings. And after that, the undigested food that goes to the large intestine, and further it is excreted outside from the body through the anus. So this is the diagram of the digestive system of the ruminants. You may draw the SOT diagram, this one. You can draw this SOT diagram, the esophagus, rumen, reticulum, omasum and abomasum. And you may also mention the four chambers. The four chambers of the, that means you may write the name, that the four compartments like this. Ruminants have a complicated digestive system. There are four chambers in their stomach. They are rumen, reticulum, omasum and abomasum. Okay, so I think the complete question answer of the chapter is discussed in previous video and this one. So please students, go through the video, and if there is any doubt, please ask in the Zoom classes. So thank you students.